Allahu 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 Allah Allahu 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 Allah هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون صدق الله مولانا العظيم برادر عمر شريف سيسترز اند برادرز السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I have 20 minutes I have to discuss with you an important subject, that is how to boost up leadership qualities among children, among students. So before I could come to the topic, I want to discuss something as a backgrounder. Can you please provide me this? This board is visible to everybody. Yeah. There are two domains of life. Yes? One is individual and another one is collective. Right? So, to run both the domain successfully, what we need? It's a common practice in our culture. Okay, it is said when you travel, if you are three, one should be?
Leader.
Simple. Okay, this is commandments, this is advice, this is guidance. So if you are traveling, you should nominate, appoint someone among three as a leader. Okay? This is the micro level of your collective life. So in the same way, if community is a group, large group, so what you would be having as a leader, he is termed as yes. Who would be the leader in the collective life, in the Islamic culture? He is Khalifa. Simple. Do you agree with this or not? Do we need Khalifa or leader to run the community or not? Yes, everybody agrees. Now, if you agree that to run a successful collective life, you need a leader.
What about your individual life?
What will be the impact of this philosophy on your individual life? Number one, you should be preparing yourself to lead. Is it or not? You should be able to prepare yourself to lead a life individually and also collectively. The part of ayah which I had recited says you have to establish the deen, establish the Islam in your individual and collective life. And this process of establishing deen in individual and collective life requires leadership qualities. Right or wrong? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. So with this background, I want to go ahead. You see, many of us are either managing a school, teaching in the school, or some of us are parents. Now let me ask very basic question. Why we have established schools? What is the objective of imparting education? What is the objective of upbringing our children? Preparing leaders for the Ummah. Everybody agrees with this answer? Why? What is your dissent? Okay, that is something different. Now my question is, do you agree with the sister's reply that our objective of imparting education is nurturing leader? He disagrees. Yes, sir.
Disagree.
Okay.
Not everybody is born to be a leader.
Okay. What about you? Okay, they are differing with the simple reason that leaders could not be everybody. Leaders are few. This is the explanation you have. Okay, now if we look into the definition of leader, what it says? The simple definition of leader is, I quote, The person who leads or commands a group, organization, or a country, right? Elder brother could be leader for younger brothers. Head of the family could be leader for the entire family. So this is myth or misconception that whenever we speak about leader or we think about creating leaders or nurturing leaders, immediately we think about either Maulana Abul Hasan Sahab or Maulana Rabe Sahab or Rahul Gandhi or Deve Gowda or big leaders, only political leaders. Okay, this is not the correct definition. Okay, they are the political leaders. But every person has potential to lead, and those potentials should be nurtured. Do you agree? Okay, fine. Now, another definition of leader is a person who influences a group of people towards the achievement of a goal. Okay, you would be preparing a generation who could influence the society or persons among whom he is living so that a desired change can be brought out in the society. Right? Now please tell me, sister, say, you are teacher or you are among the management or? Oh, you are parent, wonderful parent. Now, among the management, how many of you agree or how many of you have decided the goal of your institution? It is unfortunate that many of our top management, they are yet to decide their objective. What is the objective of your school, sir? Your Dr. Saab, I will ask you later. What about you? To impart quality education, right, sir? Same quality education, quality education, quality education, quality education. Sorry? To make them good Muslim. Holistic development, okay. Nobody has courage to tell that, yes, we would like to create leaders. Why? What is the hesitation or? Okay, once they are qualified, they will become leaders. Okay, fine, sir. You see, we are running a lot of Islamic institutions and Muslim institutions. Okay, but unfortunately, many of us who are running institutions, they don't have clarity or objective to run the institution. Many of us, they have the objective to impart quality education. What is the quality education? It's a vague term. Many of our institutions, they aim at producing doctors, engineers. Okay, is this should be the objective of any Islamic institution or an institution run by Muslims? What should be the objective of our institutions? To lead the community. Wonderful.
You should have a goal to prepare leaders, dais.
Leaders, dais. Okay. Yes. So here I have proposed some objectives. If you agree with these objectives, please think over these objectives. Okay. The objectives. Objectives of Muslim or Islamic institutions should be, number one, prepare the Quranic generation, right? Prepare the Quranic generation. Number two, why? What is this Quranic generation? They will act as Khalifa of Allah, Vicegerent of Allah. This is our basic and primary responsibility, right? Make them part of the Khair Ummah. What we are for the benefit, we will be creating welfare in the society. That is Khair Ummah, right? Prepare ultimately to reach this objective, prepare our generation, make them Salihin and Salihat. This should be our objective. To prepare Salihin and Salihat should be objective. If our institutions are deciding to impart quality education, it will be very microscopic objective of the bigger scene, which is preparing Salihin and Salihat. They will become part of the Khair Ummah. So if you make a child Salih, he will in turn become what? Leader. Okay, now the problem is how you will nurture or upbring or prepare the leaders. You see, we are very much influenced by the conventional style of our education. In our conventional way of teaching or education, we have been following rote system of teaching, okay? And what is happening in this system? It is said by a great educationist, we are doing three things. Number one, what we are doing? Okay, passing the information, transferring the information. Transferring the information from books to minds of children, right? Wow. Thank you very much, sir. I will be very brief. So, you see, we are just transferring the information from books to the minds, and we are asking children to possess this information and ultimately to reproduce this information in the examination. Right? So three things we are doing: transferring and retention and then reproduction. So one educationist has said, we are preparing our children, making them a pen drive. Pen drive will do same function what today's children or students are asked to do, okay? But to prepare leaders, it is something more required, right? So nurturing leaders require, one of our sisters say, holistic approach. What is this holistic approach? Holistic, there are various models of holistic approach. I explain a simplest model what we are adopting. We means I will not explain because Umar Sharif Saab will tell me you are doing marketing, right? So holistic approach is number one. In the holistic approach, you will be having one core curriculum. This core curriculum is about Quran, Hadith, Seerah, Islamic studies. So this core curriculum will be targeting the heart of students. And the next will be core curriculum. This is core curriculum, then the second is curriculum. This curriculum is your state board, CBSE board, IGCSE, IB, etc., etc. Then the third one is co-curriculum. So this is simplest model of creating leaders. Now, to implement this approach, holistic approach, you can use different style of pedagogies. Okay? And the pedagogy which holistic approach suggests is the approach of teacher should be a kind of tazkiyah and tarbiyah. In the holistic approach, teachers are known as murabbiya, role model, facilitators. Okay? And this facilitator and teachers, they will be transferring the knowledge, and at the same time, transformation will also take place. Right? In the process of creating or boosting leaders, you will be requiring transformation of personality, not the transfer of knowledge. This transformation requires lot of creativity, lot of homework. Teachers should be smart. You need lot of methodologies, right? You see, there is a term we call internalization. What do you mean by internalization? Please help me. We are transferring the knowledge, but we are not internalizing the ethics and converting them to morality. If we want to prepare the leaders, this internalization process is very important. Internalization process will not take place by merely transferring the knowledge, lecturing, giving homework, following the curriculum, following the textbook, workbook. No, it requires a lot of creativity. Like, for example, to be a leader, you need to create the quality of empathy. How you will create the quality of empathy among children? That needs your research, collaborative learning, classroom research. You have to come out with various modules and try to transfer the student, child, and make him a leader. Okay, inshallah, sometime if Allah gives me opportunity to interact with you, I discuss in detail. Now time is up. Thank you so much.
Barakallahu feek. Okay. Some very interesting points mentioned. As we ask Brother Umar Sharif to get ready for the next talk, a quick time for one question from the brothers and sisters. Anyone? Speaking of boosting up leadership qualities in children, and he gave a different model also as such. He defined co-curriculum, curriculum and co-curriculum. Those are very interesting points, really. Wish we had more time to ask him to expand on that. Okay, just a second, if there's any question coming away. Anyone has a question, a comment? Yes, okay. Can you just give an introduction as to your background?
Oh, I have
I got opportunity to market myself.
Right.
Thank you so much. Okay.
But you have 30 seconds.
Oh, 30 seconds because I got 30 schools.
Right.
Okay. Alhamdulillah, I am CEO of Brainy Stars International Holistic Montessori. We have 30 schools across the country and we are following the system which I could explain in brief. Okay. Apart from international schools, recently we have started Teachers Training Academy and there is one more product we are about to launch, that is Brainy Stars Learning Academy. This learning academy is to help those schools which are not performing well. We would like to take them to the next level. So this is in brief. Thank you so much.
That's a really rich experience. It's
literally walking the talk, 30 schools. I request the brothers and others who are interested, inshallah, to interact with Brother Tanveer so that you can learn a lot of things from him as to what ideas they're implementing in their schools. There's a lot of learning. So remember, this is also about networking with your fraternity, people who are already doing it. So even if you're a newbie, a startup, interact with him, inshallah, you'll learn a lot from him.